based on what people say about him. He's well respected, nonviolent. I would not expect him to be involved, okay? But I do want to wait and, on the investigation, but we have no reason to believe that he was involved in anything criminal at the time, just as people describe him, a very peaceful, loving, great entertainer.
Everyone, it is me, Asha C. Welcome back to my channel. I hate to sound so low and somber, but it's unfortunate that I have to report this news and something like this once again. So the rapper Takeoff, best known for being one third of the Atlanta hip-hop trio Migos, was gunned down in Houston, Texas on November 1st, 2022. Flashback to the year 2013, Takeoff was born in Lawrenceville, Georgia. His career began when he started performing with his uncle and cousin, Quavo and Offset. From there, the trio Migos was born. They are best known for their hit song Versace, which the rapper Drake hopped on the remix, and that co-sign further propelled them into the mainstream media. Their fame increased in 2016 with their hit Bad and Bougie, which featured Lil Uzi Vert. Though Takeoff did not have a verse on this song, he wasn't left off Bad and Bougie.
I ain't left off Bad and Bougie. You think I'm left off Bad and Bougie?
Say again?
You say I'm left off Bad and Bougie?
Other singles such as Motorsport, Fight Night, Walk It, Talk It, and so many others. Apart from the Migos, Takeoff has seen solo success as well. His first and only studio album, The Last Rocket, released in November 2nd, which is the 4-year anniversary of the release, is actually today. The album was very successful. It reached number 4 on the US charts and number 8 on the Canadian charts, followed by his solo single Casper, Going Gold. Earlier this year, the group Migos disbanded and became a duo, now known as Unc and Phew, consisting of Quavo and Takeoff. Their debut album, Only Built for Infinity Links, released October 7th, followed by their music video for their single Messy, which was released this past Monday. Now, I'm just saying this allegedly, the cause of his death was over a dice game gone wrong. According to the media platform Rap Galore Official, they've obtained some text messages that give you the play-by-play of what happened that night. These are all allegedly. I'm not sure and I cannot confirm if these text messages are true or give an accurate depiction. I'm just reading it. So let's start. The person said, so Quavo was shooting dice and he was getting his pockets broke off bad. So dude had an attitude and he tried getting aggressive with the wrong mob. Ties. Not gonna drop names. The dude got on his... and then somebody they was with jumped, and that's when everybody bunched up. Then shots just started ringing, but they were coming from somebody Migos was with. But he was shooting wild and hit Takeoff on accident, and the other dudes started shooting back. And I think he got hit again, but ultimately his own partners killed him. Because when he got hit the first time, I just seen his body drop. Quavo was plexed up over some small ish. It wasn't really worth it. Takeoff was the coolest and quietest dude in the room the whole time. He wasn't saying a word, just chilling in the cut. He didn't even know what was going on. He just jumped up and got shot out of nowhere. Houston for sure about to be a no-fly zone because mob supposed to be protecting these artists. And as you see, this was moments before the shots during the dice game. In my opinion, this picture looks kind of old, but then again, I can't really see everything and I don't know. I'm not sure who these text messages came from. It was an anonymous source, but let's continue. Around 2:34 a.m. on November 1st, the Houston Police Department rescued a call to the 810 Billards and Bowling Houston. According to the employees, after the party ended, a large group of people gathered at the front door area outside of the building. Around 40 people were at the scene at the time of the shooting, according to CNN. Two other victims, a man and a woman, both in their 20s, were wounded by gunfire with minor but not life-threatening injuries. Quavo also was not hurt at the scene. Houston Police Chief Choi said during a briefing that he doesn't believe that Takeoff was involved in any criminal activity, but the shot was not a random event. At least two people were pulling triggers. Take a look at Chief Finner's statement.
This morning at about approximately 2:34 a.m., officers received a call of a shooting in progress. Officers arrived there shortly thereafter. The location is in the downtown location, the billiards bowling alley located at 1201 San Jacinto Street here in the downtown area. Once officers arrived, they came upon a male who was deceased. That male has been identified as Kirshnik Khari Ball, better known as Takeoff. And he's a member of the Migos rap group out of Atlanta. And I want to pause again, because sometimes the hip-hop community gets a bad name. And I know, and evident from this city and people who I have a personal relationship, a lot of great people in our hip-hop community. And I respect them. But back to Takeoff. I got many calls from Houston and outside of Houston. And everyone spoke of what a great young man this is, how peaceful he is, what a great artist. And I'm calling up on everybody, our hip-hop artists in Houston and around the nation. We got to police ourselves. It is so many talented individuals, men and women, in that community who, again, I love and I respect. And we all need to stand together and make sure nobody tears down that industry.
A dice game and Takeoff's name were trending all over Twitter. Fans, media outlets, and other celebrities shared on their social media platforms their condolences, such as Drake, their label Quality Control, the singer Tank, Rich the Kid, and so many more. What's really sad is that during the press run of the Unc Phew album, they were featured on an episode of Drink Champs just 2 weeks before the death. Noriega and DJ Effin were giving Takeoff his flowers. Take a look at the clip here.
Ain't nothing little about it, you know what I'm saying?
Our show is about giving people their flowers, man. You know what I'm saying? One of the things that, you know, we want to do is we want to preserve our culture, man. And what y'all did, you know what I'm saying? Since I heard Versace, people told me that record was a year old when I heard it. Yeah. So I'm like, I don't Google, I go to Twitter. Because Twitter is like the worst, best shit in the world, right? So I went and we got y'all coming on. And people was like, yo, you know, they just made the 10-year mark. And I was like, really? And I was like, but...
We've been on the same band though. They'll go hard. Yeah, they crazy.
But you gotta realize people from the outside looking in, that's probably not from Atlanta, that probably ain't, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, everybody know
the
work.
But let's talk about the Versace. I tried to wear Versace today.
I find his death really sad because of the way that Migos ended. Both Quavo and Takeoff were not on good terms with Offset, and I can only imagine the regret that he's probably feeling right now, the hurt. Like, their family at the end of the day, like, they could break up, they could argue whatever, but at the end of the day, they are all related by blood. And they came up together and they've impacted hip hop in such a big way. Their sound, their style, their just pretty much everything has really inspired a generation of rappers. A lot of people did not see it for the Migos and they did not believe in them, but they were constantly getting co-signed from Drake to Childish Gambino to just so many others.
Atlanta, and I really want to thank the Migos, not for being in the show, but for making Bad and Bougie. Like, that's the best song ever. So just thanks to everyone and thanks so much.
And what I will say is that you don't hear anything about Takeoff. A lot of the sentiments included that how chill he was, how calm, cool, and collected he was. And it's evident in a lot of the interviews and the way that he just conducts himself. You don't hear much about him. You just hear about Quavo and Offset and everything, but you don't really hear that much about Takeoff. And I'm just so tired of hearing about rappers being senselessly killed due to gun violence. I just feel like it's entirely too much, and it's just like, what's gonna give and what is it gonna take people to stop? the gun violence. I mean, we've lost Nipsey Hussle, Pop Smoke, King Von, Young Dolph, PNB Rock. All of them were fatally shot in a span of about 4 years. And another thing that's really disgusting about the media coverage when it comes to the whole Takeoff situation is posting pictures of his dead body or posting a picture of Quavo trying to either resuscitate him or just being in grief and in shock that his family member is no longer here. That is traumatic, and it's only over a dice game. It just didn't have to go there. And I just feel like these media outlets, I get it for clicks and views, but at what cost? Like, he has a family, he has a mom, he has a dad, he has cousins, he has nieces, he has nephews. They are going to see that type of thing, and that is very traumatic to post such imagery like that. I get it, you're trying to tell the story, but I don't need an image to further traumatize me. And I hate, like, especially like TMZ, I hate when they do stuff like that. It is so insensitive. All in all, I just feel as though this type of behavior is embedded and ingrained in some people's heads. Some people feel like, okay, we're in a disagreement, so I gotta take your life. I don't understand the logic. I don't understand the reasoning behind it. It's not necessary. What happened to just squaring up, fighting? Just fight somebody, tussle a little bit, and move on and walk away. Why do you wanna take someone else's life? And why do you wanna go through the whole process of going to court, getting sentenced? Like, you cannot hide. You are going to get caught. You are going to get caught. And it's just truly a sad day in hip hop because Takeoff was very talented. He was on his way. He was such a chill and humble dude. And it's evident in what a lot of people are sharing about him. So my condolences to Takeoff's family and his loved ones. And until next time, bye. Thank you so much for watching.